Hello, are you interested in AWS Solutions Architect Professional Certification and wish someone gave you a quick list of what to study and where to get the practice exam for and where to get discounted vouchers for? Then definitely watch this video. A little bit about me. I have been with AWS for last 9 years. I've done the AWS SA Pro twice already, and I've been thinking about recertifying for the SA Pro for a year or two. And I think this is the year that I actually want to go ahead and do the certification. And that is why I actually started listing down what are the courses, what are the practice exams that I would do for myself. And I thought, let's make this video about this, that this week I learned there are different things that I could do to prepare myself for the Solutions Architect Pro certification. So definitely I want to share those with you. Hi, I'm Rohini Gaonkar and welcome back to my channel. If you're new, thank you for stopping by. I release one video every week in the ongoing This Week I Learned series where I talk about tech tips and tools. I always provide subtitles and chapters so you can skip or watch these videos in 2x speed. So let's go and check out the AWS website, the training and certifications official website, and quickly see what is this exam about. The AWS Certified Solutions Architect Professional exam is for someone who has 2 or more years of experience working with AWS services. So if you are someone who has that kind of experience, this professional certification is for you. If you don't have that much experience, then I would suggest you look at the AWS Solutions Architect Associate Certification. This certification, the professional one, is tough. Now, what are we dealing with? It is a professional level, so it is a little bit higher than the associate ones. It is a 180 minutes exam. So you have 180 minutes to complete this exam. It will have 75 questions with multi-choice or multiple responses. Now, the cost of the certification is $300 USD globally. So it doesn't matter where you're from, it's $300 USD globally. I will tell you at the end of this video, I will tell you how you can get discounted vouchers for specifically the professional exam. Once you on this page, you will also find 2 important links. One is the exam guide and the other is the sample question. So if you go to the exam guide, you will find more information about who is this exam for, what is the content. The more important thing that you should note here is definitely that the minimum passing score is 750. So that is definitely higher, considering there is 300, considering it's just 180 minutes and you have 75 questions and the scoring is minimum is 750 for you to pass. In this exam guide, you should definitely focus on the content, right? So there are 4 main domains and they're fairly distributed. The questions are fairly distributed across these 4 domains. So you should definitely go through this exam guide and understand what are these different domains, what knowledge are we expected to have in them, what are the skills that you should have when you're dealing with these different domains. The third thing that AWS officially also provides is the exam readiness course. You can find the link on the same training and certification. I will also put this link in the description below. This is available via the skill builder. And if I scroll down, I can show you that there are different videos and has certain sample questions where you can actually dive deeper into these different domains that we saw in the exam guide. And of course, AWS gives you sample questions, which are like 10 questions. It's a PDF on the website. So if you click on the sample questions, you can find these questions and the answers. Trust me, the exam questions are going to be long. So for example, this question number 6, the actual exam question could be this long. So this is going to take you some time for you to actually read through the questions, think about the answers and go through them. And that is why you should prepare yourself before you actually attempt the exam. So how do you prepare yourself? Now, before I tell you the courses and the cheat sheets and the practice exams, let me put in a disclaimer. These are not sponsored. No one has sponsored me. I wish they did, but no one has sponsored me. These are something that even I will be learning and reading from. These are the courses that I've found from people who have given this exam very recently, and they have given me a good feedback. They have given me good reviews about these different courses. So the first course that I would definitely suggest you to look for is Stephen's course on Udemy. Now, a lot of his courses for the AWS certification have had a lot good reviews and ratings. So definitely, like, it's a one of the best sellers. It's 16-17 hours of video, so you might have to put in some rigorous discipline in yourself to actually go through all of that, but I would definitely try these out. Udemy also has offers or sales going on sometimes during Black Friday or Thanksgiving, so do keep an eye on those if you are interested to have those. Now, I'm based out of Canada, so that's why it's showing in Canadian dollars, but if you open this link in wherever you're from, you will see the actual courses fees for your specific location as well. The second course that I would look for is Adrian's course, because the exam was recently updated. AWS updates exams almost every 2-3 years, so the exam has been recently updated, and Adrian's course also has been updated for the recent updated SA Pro exam, right? So I would definitely use Stephen's course to actually brush up all the knowledge that I need, and then I'll use Adrian's course to actually bridge the gap of certain things that I might not know, or those could be new in the newer exam. So I would use both of them, but that is how my strategy would be for using these courses. And the third thing is definitely I would look for Tutorial Dojo's cheat sheet. Now, Tutorial Dojo also has a whole page on the different study materials they can provide and about the exam, etc. What I like about it is these AWS cheat sheets. Now, these are not really dumps that some people would call. Now, if you don't know what a dump is people get the questions and the answers as same as they have been in the exams. So they want to just mug up the answers and go attempt the exam. I think that is why we also have to keep refreshing our questions, because sometimes people do that. But I would definitely recommend not to do it. I have not done this in my school or college. I definitely don't recommend doing it now, because you might pass the exam, but you might fail in the real world, right? So prepare yourself. If you're doing this, put in your hard work and prepare yourself for the real world. And that is why we are doing the certification, is to force ourselves to learn, study, and be prepared for actual job that we want to do and upskill ourselves. So definitely do check out these cheat sheets from Tutorial Dojo. I am also going to look at it. They also have something called as a learning path. I've not gone through it deeply, but I would also suggest you to check out the learning path and cheat sheets from Tutorial Dojo. The second thing is practice exams. Now, you have to make it your muscle memory. See, there is 180 minutes. There are 75 questions. And I told you, they are long. These questions are quite long. Sometimes the answers are also like 1 or 2 paragraphs each. So you don't have a lot of time really to sit there and ponder, like, how do I answer this question? You have to get instinctive. You have to be quick. You have to have that sense of urgency to actually answer that question quickly and move on. Because there are no negative markings. If you answer a question wrong, you won't get minus. But if you don't answer a question, you will lose the marks for that. So aim at answering all the questions and hopefully answering all of them right. And how do you do that is getting a lot of practice, because there's less time and more questions and they are difficult. So practice exams are very important. Even if you know about AWS day in, day out, like you've worked on it and you know about it, go through practice exams, because they are going to not just prepare you for answers, but they're going to prepare you with that sense of urgency. Like, they're going to prepare you, how do I answer so many questions in so many minutes? So definitely look at practice exams. And I have personally used WizLabs before, so I would definitely recommend WizLabs. You can just buy their practice tests if you have to. Like, you can just buy their practice test, and they do have offers as well. You can buy this practice test and give those exam questions, and they do provide a lot of practice questions, right? So you can definitely do that. The third thing is definitely check out the frequently asked questions or FAQs of the services that I'm going to mention now. this is a professional certification. So I assume that you are already an associate level person, right? So you already are aware of the fundamentals of services like EC2 and VPC and IAM. You are aware of fundamentals of these services. For the professional, I would recommend you to read through the frequently asked questions or FAQs for serverless services, more like serverless services like SQS, DynamoDB, API Gateway, also services like ElastiCache, Kinesis, and DMS. Okay, so these are few frequently asked questions that you should definitely read through. The fourth is definitely AWS white papers. Now there are lots of AWS white papers. I would recommend four white papers that you should read through. One is the AWS well-architected framework. The second is the security best practices. Third is the CI/CD or the DevOps one. And the fourth is the VPC connectivity options. I've given links to all four white papers in the description. So you can just click through them and read through them. But what I want to say is that well-architected framework is something that should be like, it was my Bible, honestly, when I was a solutions architect, because I've done a lot of well-architected reviews with my customers, and it gives you a different perspective about how you want to build solutions on cloud. And this, there's nothing better than this white paper to prepare you for the SA Pro certification. And security is definitely important. DevOps is also important. You need to understand microservices. You need to understand CI/CD and a lot of other stuff around that. And hybrid and hybrid architectures and migration tools, that is something very much highly seen in the SA Pro exam. So I would definitely ask you to look at the VPC connectivity options as a white paper. I would provide a link to that. If I don't provide a link to that, I'll definitely provide you a documentation link, which will give you some idea about these different topics. Now that I've talked about these things that even I will be looking for and you should be doing, let me tell you quickly, the thing that I've been promising is how you can get discounted vouchers for these exams, right? So you should join the AWS Get Certified Professional Challenge, right? This is a challenge that is running from now till 28th April, right? 28th April, 2023. So join this, just register for this. There's nothing more you have to do. You just have to go and register and you will get a 50% discount voucher towards your exam for the professional. So now we heard there are solutions architect professional and DevOps engineer professional, but you can get your certification voucher for the SA Pro exam. And the bonus tip here is definitely there is a Twitch show that runs every time AWS has this Get Certified Challenge. There is a Twitch show that actually runs. So definitely do check out that Twitch show. It's live. You can talk to the instructors live. You can ask your questions. There are a lot of people who are like you, learning with you. I have done a Twitch show. I had done that Practice Makes Practice, the last episode of the Power Hour Architecting exam. I'll provide maybe a 30 seconds clip towards the end of this video, so you'll know how much fun it is. But definitely go ahead and check that out and sign up. The link is on that Get Certified page. You'll find three episodes are already done and I think three more are to happen in this month. So definitely do check those out.
The finance company is facing poor write performance on its newly migrated RDS MySQL database. Okay, so there is a database. On investigation, it was found that these performance issues were caused by users generating different real-time reports from the application during working hours. Oh my goodness. Which solution will you implement to improve the performance of the application when it is moved to AWS? I mean, come on. Real-time reports during the working hours from your production.
On the production.
And with that, I do want to say thank you for watching this video. Thank you for subscribing to my channel. If you have not already, then please like, comment, and subscribe. It helps me, motivates me to keep doing this, to invest my time, and get all this knowledge out to all of you for free. Thank you. See you again next week.